Hello and welcome to a much more calmer stream than usual today because it's the early morning. Got myself a nice cup of coffee. Need to start drinking it apparently. And as you might notice, I'm a disembodied head. Before we start here, I want to actually let you know that I'm not just a disembodied head. I am, in fact, a fully bodied human. And if we change this chroma key from green to magenta. Oh, that's nice. You get to see right through. Just, no, both my lips there. Both my lips are growing. But, goodness. I've never seen myself with such a lipstick before. That's a little distracting. But you'll notice this is a Because Games Matter shirt. Because games matter. Duh. Like, it's easy. So for anyone who's familiar with, extra credits, you'll appreciate that. But you can still kind of see like the happy faces. But anyways, that's why we're gonna be a disembodied head. But nonetheless, you're gonna get to see more of the game. Who doesn't like seeing more of the game, right? Sounds good. Have some coffee here. Refreshing. Refreshing. And now we're on to the not so refreshing part. Still being lost because I don't remember. I mean, I remember that I don't know what I'm doing. I mean, there's the dojo guy. Probably gonna go fight him. See if I can just outpace him a little bit. Though he seemed to just be way stronger than I was here. Let me hit this light too. There was also the race. And boy, did I get close last episode with Eric defeating that. It was so close. Just by the skin of my teeth. I'm not sure I can actually even get that close again. But I'm honestly not sure what to do outside of those two things, you know? So, luckily this whole environment is just so gorgeous that I don't really have to do much else. Let me actually swap these. As much as I feel boring for using the same old weapon here, I'm gonna go ahead. Yeah, no, never mind. This. Okay, my weapon's F2. This is where I. Oh no, it wasn't that, it was a spear. Let me actually try this one. It's a spear used by samurai on the stamina. Oh, that's so nice. Ooh, I should, let me actually test it out. The other spirit is to the Was I not using the spear? Oh dear, that was funny. I was like, wow, that spear feels awfully snappy like a sword. Okay. It feels like a spear. Oh god. Okay, well that explains a lot. We've started the day in typical, ridiculous fashion. I believe that this one does more damage. So since they both kind of feel a little uncomfortable, yeah, this doesn't feel so much worse. I mean, I think that just that combo is so sick. That might be worth actually a little bit of delay. There's not much damage. If I get to attack with a heavy weapon, and chain it so well. God, I don't know. There is delay. I'm just moving forward and kicking my weapon down during it. That's so cool. I'm gonna have to use that for a little while. Let's go ahead. Alright. Now, instead of just roaming around like a city man, go ahead and. That's the one that I clearly don't know how to get there, because that's moving all crazy like around the map. Four of these. Hopefully. This one seems more pinpointed, but I don't know that I'm going to be able to get there. Yeah, I don't know. That section kind of seems out of bounds still. Put an inventor, not going to. Okay, I could probably reach that. Pascal's bullet trap. Interesting. Okay. Let's try and go there. Oh, well, the Niagara's stuck. Oh my god, it beats the windmill. Oh, yeah, okay, we're gonna hang on to this for a little while. I didn't realize it beat the windmill. Oh, it's just a straight on attack. We're gonna keep this one for a little while. Feels nice. Feels pretty nice. I always hold down right trigger still after I start the run. This is if, like, as if I'm not holding it down, I won't keep running, which I've learned isn't the case, but it feels wrong to be able to continue to run without holding it down still. I'm glad I don't have to. It just feels strange. So I'm gonna be the. Oh no, here we go. Here's Pascal's village. Looks like it's on the other side. Thank you for just like tapping generously for me, sweetheart. Ah! Those are too good! Did exactly what I told you to. Such reliably precise communications. Decision was super great. Oh my god, have I just not gone back here before? Did I really just not explore this part of the village yet? There's no way. There's no way, I just missed a bridge. Did I ever talk to this guy? No way, I just missed this part of the village, right? Come on, go up. Go up. And my system is starting. Oh, Jesus. I'm not even somebody I just didn't save or some shit. No, yeah. I'm forever regretful that, like, the robot's just dead now. I didn't fix up the quest at the time. I didn't know it was time sensitive. I didn't know. I feel bad. There's the path. Okay. Let's see what's going on over here. Oh, is this a castle? Did I just miss it now? Wait, that place with the trees and the bushes and the leaves. Treasure, okay. Boy, howdy, I'd love to find out. Like, this is now being read in the voice of Morty in my mind. Analysis. Proposal. Find treasure. Yeah, no shit, dude. I will hunt that treasure. Okay, it's the same thing. Yeah, sorry. I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to hear you again. Yeah, dude. Proposal, investigate, and find a ton of treasure. I'm down for that. I will say, as much as I struggled last time, I like that I just sort of waltzed right back into knowing exactly what to do. That worked out perfect, man. All we had to do was look at the map and drink some coffee. jumped right down. Not afraid of nobody. I'm trying to remember if this is anywhere near where I thought the baby king feels awfully similar. Oh shit, he's still fighting. Yes, I attack faster than you should. Yeah, I do feel like this is better, because I can have a combo back and get- Oh! Doesn't interrupt me. That is one downside. It doesn't really interrupt me. Oh! Oh god. Dude, when they like don't get knocked out of their when they don't get knocked out of their stamina, that hurts. It feels bad. I think there's a lot to be said about, like, when you're passing, like, having its own merits, and passing in the wrong spot. Oh, no! And the reason I say that is because, it feels like when you have an open world like this, there's so many options. And it's because there is, right? But like, that's not necessarily always a good thing, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes that can kind of be overwhelming. Or, oh, I'm just eating shit. It can feel like, oh my god, I don't know going, what I'm doing. You can see some like really old school adventure games that were like the first to start experimenting.
This part belongs to a machine life form.
So it's junk, basically.
While lacking in value, it may be connected to the supposed treasure of the forged cave.
Oh, we just found someone's
proposal. It should be confiscated for safekeeping.
I guess we'll just bring it back to him. It's fine. I was gonna farm him, but I'm just gonna skip him. Looks like he just reloaded. He spawned all these enemies. Anyways. old school adventure games have this problem a lot. Like King's Quest, a lot of them have like super open worlds, but like you would get lost in them and not know what the fuck is going on constantly. And that's not good. Oh, right, I gotta go on the side. You know, so having a way to actually track, like, not just track progress, but like track where you're supposed to go to progress through something like a red dot system on a map, though, feels like it's kind of like taking some of the mystery out of the world, and that like moment of like awe and wonder and all that stuff. I think it's very helpful for preventing people from getting stuck. Because even with that, like, I still got stuck. And it's not super fun to be stuck. Like, I get some masochistic enjoyment out of being like, okay, alright, let me suffer, let me figure this out. But, it wasn't like a big revelation moment. I think, in fact, I'm actually just running away from where I need to go. Come on. Let me use the power of the map yet again. Yeah, no, I'm just running away, it seems. Is this? No, it's a halfling inventor. Ah, damn you, inventor. But yeah, and like, in the... Oh, this guy. I'll finish this point first. Have a little coffee. In the actual case of the kingdom, one, I just like how it changes perspective and kind of gives you that weird old-school platformy feel. Even though that's sometimes criticized today when you see it in like Crash Bandicoot for not being like true 3D and like not revolutionizing platforming the way it could. I think it's cool, and I think there's its own unique merit to it. And in that, it gives you an opportunity to like create less open worldness for that section at least. And sure, it's more linear, but if you have like that linear pathing in like this giant open world, and the world is actually open and big enough to where you can get lost in it for a significant period of time like I have. it feels good. It feels like a break every now and again to have a little bit more linear of a spot. Even when I explore and I'm like, oh, well, I could only go this way. It doesn't feel nearly as bad as the parts where it's like, oh my god, the world was too open and my brain fell out. So, I don't know, it's nice. Oh. I guess I'm not done investigating. That's kind of strange. Is the red dot ahead of me here? Oh, yeah, it's deeper. Wow, okay. I thought I was at the end. I mean, I didn't jump off the edge because I thought I had to go back to him and talk to him, but I guess I was premature in my return. There's more to be discovered yet. Is there not a path on this side as well? I guess not. Anyway, so when you get to those more like linear parts, it's very easy to be like, oh my god, this is so linear, I don't like that. But I think it's actually a nice little mental break, because if you're having to constantly like figure out with your mind where to even begin to go. Like, it's one thing to know I want to wander somewhere. Can I go north here? No, that's on the outside. Yeah. Okay. But if I don't even know where I'm going, I'm not feeling like a huge sense of wonder. Like, maybe a little bit when I accidentally like stumble into something and just am like, here's a whole new zone I didn't know existed. Like, yeah, that can induce some wonder for sure. But it's not all about that. It's also about like giving you, like managing expectations and like giving you a break. Giving you a break allows you to like actually, like, return to having expectations of, oh, I just got socked. Oh my god. It's not necessarily something that, in and of itself is managing your expectations, but it, like, gives you that time to, like, develop expectations and be like, okay, I want to be here, I'm expecting to see I'm trying to pick something up and backswing the fuck out of these guys. Like, I'm expecting to encounter these enemies or this quest from these enemies. And if I'm just, like, roaming mindlessly almost, like, just sort of hoping that something happens to me, or, like, I'm not clear on what the drop system is or the quest system or something, and I'm just sort of hoping something happens to me on an RNG basis, that's not nearly as compelling, even when it does happen. And finally, I get that moment of wonder. It's not, I would argue, deep wonderment, as if I was expecting something, and it was either exactly what I expected, or like, I actually get to see it, so I'm like, in the sex. Or, come on. Alright, I got it. Oh, I tried to dodge this guy, too. I kind of like that. Hey, level up. But yeah, it gives you, gives me at least, a little bit more rewarding, oh fuck, I forgot to use this, a little bit more rewarding experience when I kind of have an idea of what I'm going for, and even if I'm wrong about that, and my expectations are off, like, that can be a huge moment of wonder as well, because it's like, is there a drop here? Because then my, like, expectations are, if the game is designed well, like, they were changed, or they were, what's the word I'm looking for? They weren't delivered on the way I was expecting, and in doing so, it created more, or it created more surprise, or something along those lines. Double jump to get up there or something? Do I have triple jump? It's in the middle. Come on. And charge jump. Okay. Alright. I just can't do that. I like that. That's a subtle way to say it. No. Not right now. Perhaps later. Let me go back. I could have gone down. But yeah, managing expectations, I think, kind of goes without saying, is a super important part of the game. What the fuck? Like, we've seen it just in my playthrough of this game, right? And so often, I would have to fall down. I will do that. I will fall down as hard as I can. So many times, I just found expectations for things like Dark Souls and Skyrim that I can just go anywhere I see. So I've been, I can't fall down. So I've been expecting to be able to go somewhere or to like half do something that it turned out I couldn't. Oh, I can't think of that. I could probably do that. I can try that again. But then I hit an invisible wall in this game and I'm just like, ow, boo. When really I don't have any. Oh, I fucked this up. Let me try that one more time. It might be out of reach. I don't really have any actual reason to expect that I should be able to do something the way. Oh god, that's so close. I can probably do that, but whatever. Let me try it one more time, since it's a chest. One more time. Oh! Yeah, so if I, oh shit, I'm just coming from this angle. Fucking kill me. Oh my god, that's so, I'm sorry guys.
analysis. This part belongs to a machine life form.
So it's junk, basically.
It's lacking in value.
It may be connected to the supposed treasure of the Forged Kingdom.
Proposal.
It should be confiscated for safekeeping.
We'll find it at some point, baby. Oh. We'll get there. Anyway, so, like, those invisible walls, I don't actually have, like, any sort of philosophical design problem with. I mean, invisible walls are really pretty cool. That can really help. Oh, yes. Oh, I can't open that one. Let me open this one. Yes. Give me the bee. Give me the bee. But I think that, I mean, even in context we're talking about, right? Like, invisible walls can limit you from going further than you're supposed to at the time, and what would be an otherwise overwhelming open world. Alright, I just thought it was going to be slow. Yeah, it was. But if I, if it doesn't feel like it's a helpful limiting thing, feels like, oh man, I should be able to go there, and for an apparent reason. Why does it zoom out like that? Is there going to be a boss battle here at some point? That's strange. If it doesn't manage my expectations properly, and it lets me think, oh hey, this is such a free roam world where I can get lost in and have. But then there are some invisible walls and just like free room areas, or they aren't like, it looks like it would burge into a new zone, but then it just doesn't. Like that is, I would argue, an improper managing my expectations. Like there should be a way to signal that this is going to be a more walled off area, that I manage that expectation a little bit better, or in some cases the wall should just be broke down. And I should be allowed to just sort of roam about a little bit more freely. We're going for the whole free roam feel. Yes, speed. Oh, yeah, come on, speed. Oh, am I pushing something? Yes, okay. I didn't realize. I gotta go. But yeah, so like, it's just about managing expectations, I think. So far, I think this game, like, is just wonderfully designed. As much as I complain about the invisible walls, I really don't think this game is particularly able to just about its invisible walls at all. I'd say it's probably better than it does about its invisible wall usage. It's just a matter of slight, minor improvements that could be made on managing my expectations with walls. Oh my god, since you're hard to find, I assume you are super value. Does he have... Okay. Again, I want a full outfit of just machine weapons at some point. But, for now, let me do some upgrades here. Oh, that's right, I need more pickupables. Man, I've been picking up so much stuff and I still can't upgrade anything. That kind of sucks. Well, I guess that's a way to save my money. Oh, nice. Oh, four black and four white weapons. Okay. Sealed them away. Also, it's a hunt. I have to find the rest. Well, I'm going to. I will find it every goddamn one. That's easy to remember. It's the yin yang duality going on. 4 and 4. I can't remember that. Oh. Okay. Alright. Sealed shrines. It doesn't actually help me though. But I will keep an eye out for that. Yes, I can. Let's take it slow so I don't fall down the air. Give me that.
Analysis. This part belongs to a machine life form.
Yes.
So it's junk, basically.
While lacking in value, it may be connected to proposal. It should be analysis.
I would like to start
machine life form parts can be assembled in some fashion.
Huh?
Processing.
What
processing complete. Machine life form parts can be assembled into a key. Proposal.
Key.
Initiate search for a door that matches the key.
That's another thing too, while dialogue is happening, it lets me walk, but then it like jerks me back towards where the dialogue started. But in this case, where it's like I'm talking to my pod, there's no clear reason I couldn't like walk away with the pod and like change rooms. I understand why they program it that way from the dialogue start, just so you don't like go through all this and fall somewhere you're not supposed to or something like that, or you didn't want to. But it kind of would be nice if they, like, give you some sort of reason at moments like this. Because when I'm talking to a person, like, I can't just walk away from them. She's too polite, right? But if it's the pod who's chained to me and follows me, maybe if the pod was, like, clearly, like, standing somewhere and entered into a dialogue, like, animation or something like that, and would be clearly rooted, it would make sense why I couldn't walk a certain distance from them and fall in love with them and shit. Okay, I probably should have done that, like, that thing where I kind of glide, but whatever. I can shit a little bit, that's fine. Anyways. Holy shit, god, I fucking hate that scene. I'm not even gonna kill it though. Yeah, so that's just another, like, expectation management thing. Because it feels like I should be able to go somewhere. But at the end of the day, that's all like, oh, well, it feels like this to me, which is inherently subjective on my part. So if I am feeling something that turns out to not be the case, then that's on me to not be stupid and assume that just because I feel something that that's the way it's gotta be. Assemble the machine right here. I wish they were in the shape of like body parts, if that's what they are. Oh no, he said there's a key. Let me check my robots really quick. Yeah, looks like I need to move this way. Yeah. See, I like that. And this is just for, because I keep getting drawn to this red dot over here, that's the inventor guy. They're just letting me do this and giving me like a little nudge, like in case I actually do need the map. Like, hey, no, you need to go this way. We're not telling you where it is, but it's like, it's on this side. Here's a red zone. Like, you need to go that way, dude. Like, I love that. And it just helps me, as somebody who's sort of become reliant on the red dots, as much as I am sympathetic to arguing that it's good to not have maps as well, like Dark Souls, and like giving you a world with no map kind of forces certain benefits of like your experience of the game. But I'm gonna have the map system. Give me the red dots, man. Let me know. Maybe it's my expectation to say, like, okay, you're gonna have a map that's useful. Oh, fuck. I almost lost there. That helps you, like, just remember where to go so you can sort of put your brain on autopilot and talk while you play the game, for example. And it's consistent, you know? By giving me those red dots and linking it so I can kind of autopilot my way through the game while talking is in line with the expectations that I've created. And I appreciate that. So certainly not something that is required to bad game if they don't do that, but it's just, it makes things a little bit smoother, you know? It's helpful. Nice little helpful nudges. How do I get over there? I don't think going any higher will be helpful. Is there a way? I mean, I know that's someone that has already been around, but it's unexpected.
Keyhole detected. A corresponding key will likely be required.
Also, I saw the horde of guys behind me, so that spawn isn't going to freak me out too hard. Let's see that one coming a little bit. Oh, and now the control is mine with the camera again. That feels nice. Ooh, rewarded. Oh my god, super rewarded. That. Yes. Give me that undescript loot.
The key protect the grave of the king. Intruder detected. Eliminate intruder.
I'm sorry.
Eliminate intruder.
Can I, like, heal the king or something with these machine parts? Maybe I don't have to kill him. He's being very nice. Let me see what's over here. Oh, this looks like something that's gonna fight me, isn't it? Oh, this is so sad. Oh, this grave of the king. It's like an eternal guardian. Oh my god. Oh, I'm gonna cry. That's so sad. Feels bad. Dodge a pig. Do I have to kill you? I'm sorry. Am I taking damage? Yeah, break that. Oh, fuck. I dashed into it. Whoa, we took out a lot of health. Come on, we're gonna need to heal up here. He can two-shot me. I mean, he's a small one, that's fine. Let me try something like this. Oh, what, I dodged that. Oh man, that ground smash does a lot of damage, holy smokes. Oh my god, fuck that up. I'll also say, fighting this guy in 3D, after I spent so long fighting guys just like him in 2D, feels really hard all of a sudden. Like, the ability to go behind him is something that I'm like super underutilizing, but it would have felt very trivial if he was just in the free run zone. Oh shit, that's not what I meant to hit. I always fuck out of that. It's okay. Let me switch pods here. Is this chicken? No, it's block. Okay. Oop. Knock him up. I'm bad. God, this is so brutal. It's taking a lot of time to kill this dude, and I just still don't want to kill him. It's like, the 2B is like, oh, I can help you with that. Let me just be super underleveled. I mean, I really could just leave, and I feel like that's probably an option. I'm not going to miss anything, but just in case I do miss something, and then, oh, fuck, alright. But you know what I mean, like, in case if I kill him, and then it triggers something, then I'm afraid. Like, I have to see that. I can't not see it. Oh fuck, I tried to dodge that. Oh, I tried to dodge that too! Oh my god, fucking kill me. I wasted this charge again. He's using a lot of these, but it's okay. He's like the boss of this zone, so as intended. Alright, let's just wait. Getting some good ship damage on him. It's like half health. A little bit of half health. This is gonna take a while. It feels really bad. A very sad fight. Shit on this. I'm gonna have to chunk really fast or dodge really fast. Ugh, yes. Easy. Fuck. It's because I did the charge attack there that I just ate shit. I was actually okay going into that. Thought I wasn't gonna be, but alas, I was incorrect. Oh my god, alright. I'm just gonna jump to dodge this from now on. I can't keep just burning through these restorative items. Nothing, because I'm actually running low on them. Is there a block button that I'm using this right now? Why is there a move to it? Oh, okay. I'm starting to get the hang of this guy. Took me a little while, but I think I'm actually gonna be a little bit more efficient now. So I dodged the enemies. Dodge it. We're okay. All planned. Unfortunately, I can't play anything that every attack comes from that each turn. So I'm just gonna use my stick. I don't know, my leg weapon. I'm gonna play using the stick for so long. I mean, I hit you. super dense part of his HP bar. All right, that felt bad. Yep, but it revealed the red dot. Okay, now it feels good. Feels bad, but I mean, glad I did it if I had
What's
to.
This? Some kind of writing.
It reads, great. Here lies the king of our forest.
So human.
Alert, storage media found. Digitization
oh God,
and saving complete.
Movies. Jesus.
Is this the treasure?
His fucking soul or something? Lord. Can I read that? Oops. Oh my god, come on. No. Would it be in this, maybe? I'm only at 20% of the game, that's crazy. Intel, perhaps? I think so. Oh, here we go. Oh, I also didn't reload the escape plan. Whoops. Here lies the Forest King Ernst. Oh, Jesus God, this is already so too much. I have names, dude. Oh my God. Exalted individual was the earliest among us to awaken to. Oh shit, come on. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. And for this reason, did we name him our regent? Jesus. Looking to sow the seed of this will in others, His Highness distributed his own precious parts. Wow. His retainers were his first to be so blessed, followed by his subjects, and in doing so he brought forth a paradise, one made for machines alone. Through his gifts did we learn of the thing called ego, and eventually our own selves. And just as ego gives way to emotion, so too did emotion lead us to feel great loyalty to our king. But our king was too great and too kind. Having distributed his parts, it became difficult for him to function, and soon he fell into a deep and silent sleep. Jesus. Now the only path left us, his loyal vassals, is to construct a kingdom of eternal peace, one which lives up to the magnificent and magnanimous heart of our king. And so, as a sign of both our resolve and our gratitude, we leave in this place a chip made from our combined parts. Your spirit lives on in us, O great king, and so we implore you to rest in peace. Forest Kingdom, its citizens as one. Jesus, man, that's heavy. Holy fuck. Okay, and what is this? Oh no, this is totally... I did read that. Wow. Holy fuck. Man, wow. Jesus. Oh my god. I mean, Jesus, I didn't know it was that widespread that they're all people. Holy fuck. I thought it was a little bit more contained, but man, how many of them are like totally sentient now? Good lord. Like, oh fuck, this thing. Man, if they're talking about like their ego and like how it gives them like the emotion of loyalty, Jesus Christ, man. I feel bad enough. Killing the defender of the grave. I certainly do now. Huh. Are we still there? I don't think so. No, it was, right? We can go down here. Yeah. get something out of here. I really wish I could tell what I picked up. Oh, fuck. Okay, no, we're fine. We're fine. Can I look back? Interesting. Well, we're gonna go all the way back, because now I have to see if I can get over there, because I really did not jump very well, and, all the things must be explored. I see it. I think I can go there. I might be wrong. But, this is, how it's gone. So I'm gonna pass where to go. I still didn't get up there. We're only like 20% through the game, apparently, so a lot of heavy shit to go still. How many sentient machines have I killed? It's actually expecting to be able to do this time. Great. We'll go ahead and jump up. We'll go like this. Oh, I fucked it up again. Come on. Oh my god. I don't think I can make it, but... Oh man, what would possibly be up there? I would only make it on the first ledge. I don't think there's anything of importance up there. But fuck it. Might try that again later. Was he over here? Where is he? I'm gonna go get that pickup. I'm gonna mark him out. I think he was over here. He's by these gates, right? Let me bring the defiled grave to this guy and see what he has to say about his king being defiled. Oh good, you have defiled the inner sanctum as I intended. Hopefully now you will stop killing us mercilessly. Does this bring you compassion? If not, if parts are still junk, then fuck you. Weird talking machine. That's funny. I guess it would just be weird talking machine, like, after you've forgotten, like, old English from the history books. Oh, I guess this isn't old English. This is just, like, Morty. Morty English. Defeated his royal guard for me. Oh, I like this. I mean, I don't like this. I like that. Oh boy. Wow. I mean, that's good. Who gives two bolts about him? Oh no. I've been rewarded. Oh no, there's quests I'm not gonna be able to complete in the future. Oh my god, he glitches out and just say they had it coming. Oh dear, what have I done? What have I done? Oh, I could have just not completed the quest! Oh! Was it important? It was probably important, but this is probably the last quest like this I have to complete. Because it's pretty heavy-handedly, like, telling you, dude, you just shouldn't do some quests. Are you gonna give me another quest? Oh god, he just says it forever. Oh my god. My god, I'm sorry, I'll never kill anyone in this game again. See, this is an invisible wall. That I don't like. Wow. Jesus. How long is this music gonna stay like this? Oh my god. Get me out of this music, man. I want the nice levity of the forest music again. Is the forest just ruined forever now? I'm just going for all the pieces of candy right now. Yeah. Wow. Ooh, wasn't sure I could go over here. Yeah, check this out. Yeah. Oh boy. Did I not go down there? Does it not let me? No, it totally lets me. Okay. See any shiny pieces of candy. If I go down to that rock, pretty much in the future, but it seems like there's a jumpable terrain a little bit there. And I should probably save before I do this shit. I mean, I'm definitely outside a save zone, right? Yeah. Let me go ahead and not suicide. I feel so bad that I can totally just suicide and not have it be a problem. But I prefer not to lose this progress and have to go through that dialogue again. Gives me the heebie-jeebies. Let me just get the fuck out of here, man. Fuck all these fuck-ups. I'm not sure I can, yeah, not die. Great. Am I still not? Where the fuck am I trying to go here? God, this music the whole time, I've just been feeling so tense during it. I've not once felt okay. Still no other red dots, huh? These ones that are not clearly positioned. I guess that's pretty clearly positioned, but not in zones I can clearly get to. What is this garbage? What the fuck? Okay, let me save and explore that shit. Oh, thank god the vacuum works. Oh. Whew. Oh, Jesus. I'm starting to feel a little bit better now. Oh my god. Big golly. And small. I feel better. I don't think I'm gonna feel good in this forest zone ever again. Zone successfully ruined, as intended. Oh my god, that just a little bit of time to get back while saving feels so nice every time. Every time. I hope every game after this game steals that feature. Okay, since I just saved, let me see if I can go down the waterfall area. And if I can't, let me see if I can figure out what that weird little, like, section, series of rectangle sections is all about. I feel like I should be able to go in between those and kind of chain them in some way. Oh fuck. Alright, well, mess this one up. Oh nice, okay. This is probably nothing down here then, but we must explore. Oh, is this an invisible wall? Think of the invisible walls, right? Okay, that's fine. I'm okay with just taking too long. I also like that it just, like, when it's something like that, an invisible wall sort of thing, it only costs me health. It doesn't actually, like, send me back to spawn or anything like that. It's a little forgiving. And I feel like that's a good feature, given that these are things that could probably be anticipated as related to having to do with people just misinterpreting where they're allowed to be. So giving a little leeway on that is nice. I think I'm heading that way. Let me place a marker on the map so I know where the fuck I'm trying to go here. Okay, let me place it right there. I just sort of hug the wall here. Okay, I can do that. The king! What? How do I get up there? What? I'm a good golly goodness. Okay. So maybe I go down? Maybe that's just sort of an aesthetic. There's no way, though. There's no way. Let me just go down here. Don't worry, I will commit suicide. I'm sorry for trespassing. Jesus, why would it spawn me like this? Okay. Well, I guess I'll just pick up some loot. Don't mind me. Alright, if I can't explore that, where am I gonna go next? I'm definitely not staying in this zone for a long time. Feels too bad, man. Yeah, I mean, I guess I just go back to base. I also am searching for 9S, generally speaking. Yeah, I mean, I guess I'm just gonna go back to Pascal's village and upload out of here. As I definitely don't wanna be in the forest anymore. Pascal's village is still too close to the forest for my case at this point. Oh, okay. We're fine, not even a problem. I'm missing all the pickups, so I just don't care. Come on. It's fine. I probably have to go this one anyway.
We must protect our king and kingdom!
I kind of understand now why, like, they seem so much less, like, oh, that dialogue. I love that they, like, force it to play even if you clearly run past them. That's so brutal. Oh, man. Anyways. Hold on, is this the way out? This does not feel like the way out. I'm gonna go ahead and go this way. Since I keep kind of clipping against walls, I think it is not intended to be. Oh no, wait, I saw the box! Oh fuck, did I miss the box? Fuck. I mean, did you guys see the box up there? Jesus. Oh, I whiffed it. Alright, well. Clearly I'm supposed to be able to go down here at least. What is this? Oh, the mystery. Oh shit. No way. Is this that place that I like had to cheese my way through earlier? No way. No way it is. What? What? This was not how I got out of here last time. What? That's so cool. I didn't even notice this thing. How the fuck did I not even notice this, man? Maybe I just couldn't jump on it. Huh. Obvious, some of a bitch. Let me go ahead and just drop to my death here and confirm this is exactly what happens. Okay, it is. Very nice. Very nice. So I can't get up here, huh? Even though this is clearly a trail. I go around the edge. Okay. We figured it out. We figured it out, ladies and gentlemen. Give me that box. Oh my god, I don't have a fucking piece. That's fine. That's great. That's lovely. What a lovely little thing. Oh, what a nice little trail this is. Oh, what was that shiny thing? Okay, that's just clipping. That's fine. Love it. Love how that's a whole area you could, like, possibly... probably wasn't supposed to clip like that. Oh, no, I was. I love that entire area, that whole sequence. How you could just play the whole game and, like, never need to go down there, it seems. Love it. Absolutely love it. I feel like that alone is worth buying the game. Just so I can endlessly explore this and find all the little nooks and crannies. Alright, what was I doing? I was trying to get out of here. There was a reason I was headed this way. To get to a way to upload. And the fact that it looks like I'm just gonna go this way. Whatever's over here. I think this is the, like, beast tamer part, yeah? This is, like, the one part of the forest I can still feel good about. This is still offline, unfortunately. I'm just gonna go back to command. Even if there's not a red dot there, I'm gonna see if there's actually something to do. Getting low on coffee, we might have to go refuel at some point. Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's dude here looking at the map. Let me just go talk to some people and double check that that's correct. God. I love the action lines. Like, do you see the action lines after I've been running for a little while? Like, there. Those little, like, speed lines. They're like a lazy way to animate motion. But, like, look at this. It's so nice because it doesn't go until, like, I've been running at top speed. So, once it truly tops out... Oh my god, I want to get in there. Once it truly tops out, it just feels... Oh, this isn't where I wanted to go, shit. Well, since I'm here, I might as well do a little shopping, right? Do my free pickup every time. And check out my upgrades. Don't have my stuff. That's too bad. Look at fusing some shit. Can't I do it? Oh, it's because it costs too much. Oh, wait, no. No, it's not. I just don't have something to fuse it with. Yeah, that's what it is. Okay. Very interesting. Oh, I do have some plus anti-damage. Okay. These ones are plus 5 already. Yeah, let me go ahead and... I'm gonna go ahead and fuse these. It's only 2,000 gold. Not that bad. Why would I not? Why would I not do that? Wait, what? Why is this an option? Is it because it doesn't change? No matter which of these I choose to fuse it with, it doesn't change what the upgrade is. Is that true though? Hold on, let me save first. Yeah. I know you're not gonna say if I ever feel dissatisfied I can undo a fusion, so I don't know what that dialogue was, but I knew it's not what I was hoping. Let's go ahead and try this. Let's explore this a little bit here. Oh, fuck. I think it was this, right? Yeah. Let's fuse like this. There's a plus 2 that's got the little star thing, right? But what if I... Let me load and see what we're looking at here. If I fuse it with the other one, does it keep that little square symbol? Because it might just give me the square symbol bonus of leveling up, but it itself might not carry over the square. Oh shit, I was all the way over here. Whatever, that's fine. Wasn't hanger. This one. Stamina. I probably actually could have just done this by using another one that kind of fit this description, but oh well, I'm taking a little bit of my time. That's fine. Okay, so we'll do this, because look, it should be the same. Okay. No, it's still carried over. Huh. So I have a second one that's... Okay. That's definitely worth doing. Maybe it's like a lottery? Let me try this. I'm just gonna keep upgrading this to see. No, it carried it over the whole time. It doesn't look like it was any different. It was a 9, right? I'm just gonna burn through a lot of gold here. Bear with me as I test, right? Oh, I actually can't test it like that. It doesn't matter, whatever. That's fine. Okay, it seems like it keeps it as long as you equip it once with something. It does matter a little bit with the size. It doesn't necessarily seem to matter too much. Like, there seems to be like a breakpoint, right? Like, it must take some sort of average. Like, every 2 you go up, it goes up 1, it looks like. Let me go ahead and undo all this shit. Like, I'm gonna look at each time I go up, I'm gonna see if there would be, if I'm within one of myself, like one slot size, I shouldn't try and fuse it with the same like upgrade, because it would average out to be the same anyways. But if it's within that range, I can upgrade it no cost in slots, so I should. I must min-max this. I must be as optimal as possible here. Because I only have so much space now. I've already maxed out how much that is, and if I have a limited space, I must play this mini-game of min-maxing. Alright, so, again, we'll use the anti-chain damage, right? So these anti-chain damages are going to be 5 anyway. Right, or 6 rather. So it doesn't matter what I choose to upgrade this through, right? I'll upgrade it through this one. I have the option to do that again. But let me see here. So since this is 8, pushes it to 8, perhaps? Let me try something here. It's gonna move it to 5 anyway, so if I use it with a 5, no, it moves it to 6. Okay. I do have to do it like this. And then let me fuse 2 of these together. That's another 6, right? Let me see. See, there is a slot difference. Okay. So it's possible to save a slot there, so I will. And it's possible to save another slot here. Well, I'm almost certain it's possible to save another slot here. Because look, if it's unupgraded, it's already at 8. And if it's averaging like that, there's no way it's going to stay at 8. It would have to go up to at least 9. And if that's a plus 2, the thing that makes me feel weird is this. Right, see how it's got the chip sign? Does that mean it's equipped right now? Let me check my pod. I don't remember our bills? Yeah, pod program or plug-in chips. What do I have equipped? I think that just means I'm equipped. Anti-chain. Yeah, okay. It just means it's equipped. That's fine. Continue to fuse here. Yeah, we'll go ahead and fuse it with another starred one. Because I think what it means is at the lower ranks, it's close enough to where you can just fuse them with non-star ones to sort of like retain your star at a higher level. But then on, you have to keep fusing it with starred ones. Otherwise, you start to take up more slots. So I think this is worth doing. Because again, we can see that this is 8. So even if I fuse it with a starred one, which I don't have available anymore. But if I did, I bet it would still be a 9. Because it still has to go up. And a 9 is significantly more than a 7. So it would be at least a 10 instead of a 9. So I'm going to go ahead and equip this. Or I'm going to go ahead and fuse this. I think unequips that out of my thing. Which is fine. I'm okay with that. Why can't I fuse this one? Oh, because they're all plus 1 already. Okay, I see. So I can do this, but yeah, it's already so much. Let me just save that for now. I want another starred one, it seems. What other sort of starred things do I see? Deadly heal? I don't see another one to fuse with that's starred though. Maybe if I... Yeah, if I fuse it with another one, that'll only be 6. So fusing it with a 6 probably wouldn't be bad. This 9 is definitely bad, but a 6 is probably equal to a 5. It's possible I'm missing 1 because I don't know if it's odds or evens. Where it jumps up a slot. It might be like if it's 2 more compared to the one it's already at. It's already going to go up to 6, right? So I think fusing with a 6 would be within the boundary. So let's go ahead and make a 1. Yeah, see? Then it's already within 1, but now that it's 2, it goes up. And this one's an 8, but it still fuses to a 7, so it's not capped by what the max is. It's like a ratio. So I can always do within 1 and have it be fine. So let me fuse like this. Then I can fuse like this to still be within my 6. Yes, I do. Great. And I don't want to do anything like that because I could probably make one that's pretty good here. But I wouldn't have enough to make one that's pretty good twice, right? Like this would be good. But this one's a little off, and then I'd have to fuse both those together just to get one that's like still kind of off to fuse with this. I'll just wait for now. It's not super important to me that I immediately get more deadly heal, so I'll wait to be perfectly efficient with that. Let me check out these pluses. Other stars, rather. Other stars do I have? I could do some max HP fusion here. Probably want to do it like that. Because a 6 would be too much, so we'll go ahead and upgrade this one. Even though I'm probably not going to use this. I might use it. I might have enough space now where I can use it. But I think since I've upgraded the ones I had equipped so much, that it's probably not going to be worth it. I'm probably going to have taken up more space because I'm, even though they're smaller and more efficient, they're higher level. Excuse me. I might not have the space I want. I feel like there might be stuff with move speed I can do, but I don't see any starred ones. I just see a couple of them. I thought I had a lot of move speed, but I guess I really don't. I guess I am incorrect. Okay, if I do this, it's a 6. So then, if I do this, it would only be with a another plus 6, so that would be fine. This is efficient to do. Do this, and then I can fuse this with a 6. Oh no, okay. Okay, I freaked myself out for a moment there. No, we're still good. So that's still an efficient plus 2. Okay. Great. Great. Very well. If I remember right, Eric said I can only discover these like little enchanted ones. I can't do anything to sort of upgrade them to that, so that's fine. That's fine. Okay, great. I'm happy with that. Let me go ahead and make sure I've got all of them active still, because I don't think I do. Let me start by optimizing. I got that space, but I think that means that some of them unequipped, right? Let's start with what we don't have here. There's our deadly heal. Let's re-equip that. And our anti-chain damage. Okay, no, so it's so efficient that we still have a little bit of space left over now. It's not perfectly efficient anymore. It's just 1, right? Yeah, just 1. So I don't think there's anything that just requires 1. No, there is. Save points. I'm not even gonna equip that though. That's already on there. Yeah, I mean there's some things, but it's not worth it. I don't want to get used to relying on a HUD thing or forget that I have one particular HUD thing equipped. No. I'll just be a little inefficient, that's fine. I'm working towards getting this, because that would be nice to just have that on top. Not really needed per se, but Since it's an efficient thing. Same thing with this. Like, this would be nice to just throw in there. That's fine. Oh, this is really needed. This would be nice. I'm definitely hunting this. It's something I would like to have next. But I think we just gotta get a little bit more efficient. That's fine for now, though. We've leveled up a little bit. Made ourselves nice and efficient. Alright, let's go talk to the boss. Very nice, I'm happy with that. That feels good. That feels... Something about min-maxing just always feels nice, you know? Take that. Head on over to the boss. Is there an icon here that I needed to go to? No, okay. I'll go ahead and get some more of this stuff since I'm right here, though. Get a couple more of these. Let's go nuts. Treat ourselves. I'll get one more. Oh, that's two. Well, I'll get two then. We're going nuts, like I said. I am tempted to sell all these, like, temporary things. None of these, though. Maybe some HUD stuff I could sell, especially the ones that I can't use. can only be equipped in easy mode. Oh, they're only 28 gold. Yeah, it's effectively useless to sell. Whatever. I'll hang on to it anyway. I'm a hoarder. Why not have 999 of everything, you know? Boss. So that's the thing, like, I gotta just sort of explore and hope I stumble across more of them. Because it's not really gonna mark on the map where they are, because I wouldn't know where to go. Like, that makes sense. Is there another save point here? Yeah, very nice. We'll go ahead and save. I'm happy with that. I don't think there's anywhere in particular that I really need to go. I know that this place as a save, right? So I just gotta find a way to get back there. I don't really remember how I got there in the first place. It's a little problem, though. Resistance camp is just offline. Let me start at the cave. And we'll try and find our way back to the coast. Because I've been there before. And if I get over there, maybe I can reactivate that save point. It might just be being blocked by, like, a horde of, like, level 1 machines that are just, like, gathered around it, but... Oof. Man, this game's a toughie, man. I'm thinking about that, and it's like, man, are those machines sentient, though? Like, I don't know. I don't know about that zone. That zone is one I shouldn't be attacking. Oh, that's what this one is. Okay, well, I think I might pick up first one here. Let me mark this on the map. Get over here. No. No. Where is the... I didn't get over here as much as it seems like I should be able to with the path like that. It wasn't this way, apparently. What was it? It wasn't these guys. There it is. Okay. So that'll give me in the general direction. Yeah, man, this game's heavy. Hurts my soul. This is intended. Oh! This is intended, though. As I say that, know that I love that, and I wouldn't have it any other way. That is why I purchased the game so readily. Always gotta go through the whole thing before you can just get a sense of, like, no, this game's going somewhere. I'm only this percentage of the way through the game, and it's already giving me some shit. It's like, alright, the rest of this is gonna be an interesting fucking thing. This little experience. Let's go ahead and make sure we get the most out of this. So last thing I'd want to do is have, like, play through the game a significant chunk. Then actually start to get irritated with, like, frequent crashes. And then have it to detract from the game experience. So. Let's go up to the racer. I thought this was the one that I couldn't reach, but I guess it's the race point. Wait, why is he back here? Didn't I already race him further than this? Don't tell me it doesn't, like, you know, you think you can fight with your blaster energy that way? Yes, that's quite a lot. Okay, no, this is the same one. Alright, let's go for it. Here we go. Here.
Three, two,
let's do this.
One,
I'm going in try hard mode. You can tell if I'm like leaning forward, I'll focus like. Well, okay, didn't use too much time. Hacking was a little inefficient though, but not so bad. No, darn, not quite. Alright, fuck him. I don't remember how I did so close that one time. Yeah, fuck him. He's not who I'm after. That was each other. It had the little, has the little hanger things over it. Little cloth hangers. This might be the suit place. Yes, right. Suit place. Very well. That slide also feels very efficient. I'd like to be able to just drop down, but you know, fine. And just fine. Okay, this feels like I'm on to something here. Let's see what the map looks like when I pop out. Okay, not quite where I was expecting to be. Let me check, see where I'm at. Okay. I might be able to find some way down through here. Let's go ahead and explore. I don't think so. But I've been wrong before. Let's see. Let's poke out over here. God, that's like this part of the soundtrack. Under the wall, why? I'm right there too. I'm certain I can go over there. Come on. I can walk all the way over. Perhaps not. I can't go any further, huh? Come on. Come on. There you go. I think this is the dead. Oops. Yeah, this is the dead end. Let's check very briefly for any other ladders that might be around. I could always go back and watch my old videos and remember how I got there, but that seems like the cheapest possible way. I can't jump like that. Let me explore the factory area because there's still a red dot there. Let me just try and clear it and see if that does anything. I'm pretty sure I've been there before. I'm just not quite figured out why it's a red dot yet. Transport to the factory. Yeah, we'll just go entrance. It's probably fine. I wonder if this heals me. I hope it doesn't. I hope it sticks to the damage. We'll go ahead and clear out this factory, and then if I don't find my red dot clearance along the way, we'll go ahead and take a pause, get some coffee, and rethink our strategy here. Oh no, is this not the right place? No, this is the right place. How did I go over here? This way. Whiffed it. Just gotta remember not to run off the edge of the world. There we go. Alright. Get into the gray area. I think is where the red dot resides. That's it. I bet you it's inside one of those doors. I think it's back here, okay, though. I'm trying this. I'm going through that way yet, but looks like this way takes me slightly over that direction. Oh Jesus, it's like super far beneath, that's right. Kind of in a corner, let me just keep going. Mark it from here. That'll kind of give me a little bit of a view from the top down perspective. Clear these guys out along the way, and then they'll probably respawn by the time we get back here. But whatever. It's fine. It's fine, just fine. Well, I just tried to run through it. One shot. Feels good. Okay, it's going to be taking me away from that direction. Well, I'm kind of going towards it now. Let's see. Who pops out of here? Whoop. Chest. Come on. Dang. Come on. But I'll take it. So I'm generally heading towards it. It seems pretty far enough. Seems kind of over there. Doesn't seem to be moving too much, but it seems to be kind of off in a different space. Maybe I can go that way once I get down. I'm not sure where this drops to. Let's see here. Okay, now this drops the other way. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is all Alton sort of thing. Just in case. There's some chance that it... Yeah, that's gonna send me back this way, just like... Oops. Well, I mean, so much for clearing this place out, right? Yeah, it's sent me over this circle area. Is there nothing I can do over here? Is there a body waiting for me to grab in here? Which I already did. It. Sure. Darn. I don't know how to get over to that part of the factory. Which probably means it's one of those doors I just can't open yet. That's fine. I shan't kill you. Not out of compassion, but because simply not worth my time. It's okay, worth exploring one more time. I think I kind of definitively know what the deal is here with that red dot. I'm somewhat certain it's a door I can't open yet. Once I can get whatever sort of chip or upgrade lets me open those doors, some sort of card clearance or whatever, I'm going to have so much more to explore that. Gonna be insane. Alright, well I feel good for having and check that probably for the fourth or fifth time now. But feels good. If I can't get that one, it gives me a pretty clear. It gives me a pretty clear guide. That red dot's just out of access, so I'm gonna have to explore the other red dots. Even if I buy more from the sunning and this. I can explore that route. I don't have enough gold to fund his research just yet, though. He was very spendy. And it looked like whatever I was spending for when I accidentally got a spoil for myself was just something way down the line, so I didn't really need any of that stuff just yet. Let's go ahead and get looking elsewhere. Again, I think I'm just looking for the bodies. Friends? Mobbly units? Not sure what friends. But allies as they were. I'm also looking for 9S. I mean, I didn't miss good for anybody, right? Very look. Yeah. And they've gotta be by the Sunken City. This is where that red dot is. I don't remember where I got them. I just truly, honestly cannot remember how I pathed over there. I remember it was Wonder, and it was like, ooh, look at this new zone. Cleverly hidden. And it was so clever that I don't even remember how I did it, and I can't figure out how to replicate that. Before we start exploring, yeah, let me zoom out. So if we're not doing that one, not doing Speed Star, not doing the Inventor, we've just got some exploration. If we explore the desert area, I suppose. I'm very certain that it's over. I don't know about that one. Probably a similar thing. I guess I'll just go back to Resistance Camp real quick since I'm already kind of by there. Check out, see what's going on. Talk to everybody, make sure I'm clear on talking to everybody. Refresh my memory of if there's anything that I sort of forgot to do. Maybe I need to drop off one of those photos for Memory Girl. Get him to stop just so I can update over here, no? There's a little place off the side here, yes? Huh? Yes, alright, good. I'm internalizing the map. Very well. I'll accept this progress. There was a way. Oh shit, was there a way back through here? Was that how I got there? Fuck, maybe it was because I opened the shit. Excuse me, sir. I opened shit back here. Nothing. Here. Okay. did talk to some new people back there, but that was it. And talk to this guy back here for fun over his head. You. Friends need you. That's a good line. Oh.
What's up?
Then I can't upgrade any of these. He doesn't have anything I could buy anyway. Once I approach the target of the scanner, I can make it visible. They're not going to, apparently. Whoa. Oh, that's pretty nice. Wait, it takes up zero slots? No. That's I have zero. Okay, I was like, what? Okay, that's cool. I definitely want that. I'm not gonna do that, I'm not that lazy, but I want that. Outdated though, I'm not sure about that one. Looks like a heavy weapon, I'm not sure that's better than Beast Man. It might be. Let's see, 130 to 120. 280 to 360. Oh, I could have just gone and sell. 182. Oh shit. Oh my god. What? Whatever. Fine. Sell. Beast Tamer. Weapons at any point now. Pass them? Can I sell them my weapons? Guess not. Yeah, oh, okay. Oh, okay. Weapons. Yeah, let's go back and look good. Yeah, no, I think these are better. Okay. Pretty sure those are better. Talk to this man. He doesn't have any of the starred ones that I could buy, so I'm not really interested in that. There's probably a way that I could, I just can't believe I didn't get that yet. There's probably a way I could optimize, like, buying the ones that I already have the starred ones for, but, that's fine. What? They both have the same dialogue? Oh no. Huh. Hey, I have a qualm. Please narrate why you guys designed it that way. That's funny. I like how retro it is. It's kind of a hipster thing. That's funny. Hint, hint. Maybe you should just walk places. Oh, that's funny. I like that. Definitely not gold. like those dialogues. That was nice. A nice little fourth wall. To go through that little dialogue tree. Not like a hidden pathway I didn't know about back here. Okay. So let me remember here. Let me equip my pod. Is he the one that...
picked up a response on the scanner.
Oh. Oh, that's fast. How do I scan? Picked up a response. It doesn't really work on the map. Okay. Shit, that's so inconvenient. Is it a key item? Rip. Okay, there we go. Here's what I'm gonna do. Let me equip. How do we do this? Chips. Can you use this? Customize. Chips. Let me get some additional HUD stuff on here. Let's see what I'm picking up. Wait, where's my. I guess I do. I mean, I thought for sure there was something, there's a reason I wasn't being told that anymore. Let's go running around the map, man, with this puppy out. Yeah, for a little exploration. it really sucks to be moving slow in this. Hold on, let me log in. Move speed. Already at plus 20. That's fine. We're fine. That's all well and good. It's fine, I'll just keep going. So these are just like... Yeah, if this is just like gold and like... pick-upables, I'm not really gonna rely on the whole map doing this. I'll go for one more of these hidden objects, and then I will fall again. Shit, it was down here. Alright, I think I already have that too. Yeah, look at that. Okay. Alright, well, let's go ahead and put ourselves back on our... our different plugins set up. Man, how do I get to... how do I get there, man? Thank you. I get to the flooded city? This is a tough one. I honestly might have to just look it up online, because I really just am at a loss. Like, I hate to do that, but I am at a loss. Tell you what we will do, though. We'll take a quick break. But a quick break. And get some more coffee. Because unfortunately, see this? This needs to be full. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And we'll be back. I'll see you in just a few moments. Thanks for hanging out. Be right back.